Greetings and a warm welcome from me, astrologer Patrick Arundel. Today, in the latest of my Inside Track videos, I'm going to explore the third of four Mercury Kazemis that are occurring this year. This one's on the 6th of September at 11:08 a.m. Universal Central Time in the sign of Virgo at 13 degrees and 36 minutes. What is a Mercury Kazemi? Well, it's an old Arab term for when a planet is in a very close conjunction with the Sun. So in other words, it has to be within 17 minutes. But this is an exact event. And essentially, it means that the planet is in the heart of the Sun. And that's particularly true of this event because of Mercury's retrograde. Mercury is indeed passing between the position of Earth and the Sun, so it's in between us, and it's known as an inferior conjunction. Now, this actually intensifies its power. So the energy of the Sun, the radiance of the Sun, amplifies the brilliance of Mercury in the sign of Virgo, where it's exalted, but also the domiciliary ruler of the sign. So really, really exciting. So I'm going to go through with you some of the themes of Mercury in Virgo, understand where we are in that retrograde phase, which is going to go on through to the 5th of October. And I'm also going to just highlight when the other ones occurred. All of them this year are in Earth positions, even though Mercury does, right at the end of the year, just rewind in the sign of Sagittarius, just very briefly. I'm also going to share with you the event chart from a Placidus viewpoint, which has an ascendant in Scorpio, and there's a glorious link between the Sun and Mercury and Jupiter itself in a retrograde now, and also a semi-sextile to Venus. If you're new to my channel, thank you so much for joining me. This is very much a community. If you have any thoughts, please share them. I do try to interact with all the comments. And also, if you're a returning visitor, I really appreciate your views. And if you've subscribed, those too. If you've yet to subscribe, I'd be honored if you did so now. Please click or tap on the bell notification symbol. And also, please also like the video too. So let's just check out those Mercury themes. First up, Mercury is an androgynous planet, so it's very much a planet for our times. And of course, it governs two zodiac signs, Gemini, but the earthy Virgo too. And here it's very much about messages, of course, as always. It's an intermediary. It's in Virgo very much about precision, concentration, discrimination, being meticulous, maybe a bit cool, practical, very rational, sharp, and can focus on small strands, but to the exclusion of the big picture. So sometimes one of the things we need to push back on with Mercury in Virgo, or a lot of Virgo energy, is that we could then be a little irritable or intolerant. So we need to sometimes widen the focus just to see that whatever we're really zoning in on, which is a good thing to do because Virgo energy wants us to produce something that's of tangible benefit. And often that's assisting or helping others in some kind of practical way because it's an earth sign. Now let's just check out that retrograde. The pre-retrograde shadow began on the 4th of August at 8 degrees. Now the retrograde itself began on the 23rd of August at 21 degrees. And it's going to go direct on the 15th of September at 8 degrees, the same day as we have the Virgo new moon. And then it leaves its post-retrograde period on the 30th of September at 21 degrees. So there's an absolute symmetry to this process. So this Kazemi happens halfway, exactly halfway through the retrograde period. Now remember I said to you that we've already had one Mercury Kazemi in Capricorn, which was the 7th of January. We then had one in Taurus on the 1st of May. We've got this one in Virgo on the 6th of September, and then the final one is the second one in the sign of Capricorn, which is the 22nd of December. Now let's just share with you that event chart on the screen. So there we have the ascendant in the intense sign of Scorpio, but it's in an absolutely fantastic sextile with Mercury and the Sun. So I think that's really interesting and brings a more passionate dimension to things, but a more scrutinizing energy, but perhaps from a more psychological or transformational perspective. But the big takeout is that Mercury and the Sun are in house 10. So that's how we link to the wider world. So it therefore can be about our jobs, our responsibilities and obligations. That's always part of the Virgoan story, but maybe where we need to be more conscious of the big picture, the 10th house, is a bit Capricornian. Now we can also see that on the descendant, we have Jupiter. So that's really terrific for relationship potential. And that's linking back to Mercury. So we've got the two planets of the communication, the message of Mercury and the planet of trade in the Earth sign of Taurus, very much about money, are in an exact trine of 120 degrees, along with the Sun, of course, which is very enabling. So Jupiter trine the Sun in its own right, which becomes exact on Friday at the end of this week, an absolutely cracking influence, very, very enabling. But this, of course, is very much about expansion, but with Jupiter retrograde and in the earthy, slower sign of Taurus, makes us think about, if we're talking about trade or contracts or discussions around agreements, that we're thinking things through carefully. Now, one of the things about having a Mercury Kazemi is the brilliance of Mercury is amplified, as I mentioned before, but we've got to have the confidence to work with it. And there are so many people who feel that if Mercury's retrograde or Jupiter's retrograde, you can't do anything at all. Well, Jupiter is retrograde for a third of the year. Are we going to do nothing around trade from now to the 31st of December when it goes direct? I don't believe that's a logical thing to do. Obviously, Mercury is very logical, very cool and rational. And of course, the Mercury retrogrades themselves take a total of 10 weeks for each one, usually the retrograde itself about 23 days, but the whole process takes 10 weeks. And of course, we have had this long period of Mercury in Virgo. So if little niggles have been frustrating you, or your nervous system has felt a bit depleted, you know, hasn't been quite as much physical energy, it wouldn't be a surprise, because of all the planets that have gone through Virgo, had to go face to face with the restrictive energies of Saturn in the sign of Pisces, the more psychological domain, whereas Virgo, the more practical domain. So this event actually gives us a big pep up. We don't have to wait until the 15th of September to think that we can galvanize ourselves into action to do something constructive, do something positive. Don't let people tell you you can't do things. You can, but you have to do them with purpose, Jupiter, and you have to do them with precision, Mercury, but also let the Sun come into the equation, and that's to do with confidence, self-belief, and action. It's been a real pleasure being with you. If you'd like to take advantage of my very special offer, if you order your year 2024 personal horoscope forecast based on your unique birth data now, I'll prepare for you the rest of year 2023 free of charge. But also my special package, I'll prepare for you your character analysis report, your life roadmap, which will give you searing insights into the patterns, a more intimate understanding of the patterns that have played out in your life so far. And all this information will help you to go forwards in a much more informed way. Please see the link below for more. But for now, take care. Please like, comment, share, or subscribe.